In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Well, good day to you. Good morning to you. We celebrate Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. And you'll already have noticed that there are some differences when we celebrate Lent. First of all, there's a silent entrance, no hymn, no entrance hymn. And also the prayers and the various imprecations in the Mass are made in a monotone, going back to a tradition in monasticism. This is to show that Lent is a solemn period, as distinct from other seasons of the year. We are celebrating Ash Wednesday for the first time in lockdown and in a COVID situation, so again there are some differences in the way that we distribute ashes. We can't impose them on your forehead in the normal way, but we go back again to a much more ancient tradition, going right back to Judaism, where we sprinkle ashes on your head. Now, it's no good saying you've just had a hairdo, because nobody can get a hairdo this time, so that's not an objection I will accept. However, if you do have any problems about receiving ashes in that way, please demonstrate that by crossing your arms over your chest, bowing, and I will give you a blessing instead. But otherwise, the way we receive the ashes, according to the directions of the Vatican, are that they should be sprinkled, just a very small amount sprinkled in your hair. So if you would bow as you come forward. But we will go through this again in a moment. There is no penitential rite today because the distribution of ashes takes the place of that. So we go straight into the opening prayer because, of course, in Lent there is no Gloria either.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
From the prophet Joel. Now, now, it is the Lord who speaks. Come back to me with all your heart, fasting, weeping, mourning. Let your hearts be broken, not your garments torn. Turn to the Lord your God again, for he is all tenderness and compassion, slow to anger, rich in graciousness, and ready to relent. Who knows if he will not turn again, will not relent, will not leave a blessing as he passes. Oblation and libation for the Lord your God. Sound the trumpet in Zion. Order a fast, proclaim a solemn assembly. Call the people together, summon the community. Assemble the elders, gather the children, even the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his bedroom and the bride her alcove. Between vestibule and altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, lament. Let them say, spare your people, Lord. Do not make your heritage a thing of shame, a byword for the nations. Why should it be said among the nations? Where is their God? Then the Lord, jealous on behalf of his land, took pity on his people. The word of the Lord.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. We are ambassadors for Christ. It is as though God were appealing through us, and the appeal that we make in Christ's name is to be reconciled to God. For our sake, God made the sinless one into sin, so that in him we might become the goodness of God. As his fellow workers, we beg you once again not to neglect the grace of God that you have received. For he says, at the favourable time, I have listened to you. On the day of salvation, I came to your help. Well, now is the favourable time. This is the day of salvation. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. A pure heart create for me, O God, and give me again the joy of your help. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be careful not to parade your good deeds before men to attract their attention. By doing this, you will lose all reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give alms, do not have it trumpeted before you. This is what the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets to win men's admiration. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you give alms, your left hand must not know what your right hand is doing. Your almsgiving must be secret, and your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. And when you pray, do not imitate the hypocrites. They love to say their prayers standing up in the synagogues and at street corners for people to see them. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you pray, go to your private room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your Father who is in that secret place. And your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. When you fast, do not put on a gloomy look as the hypocrites do. They pull long faces to let men know they are fasting. I tell you solemnly, they have had their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that no one will know you are fasting except your Father who sees all that is done in secret. And your Father who sees all that is done in secret will reward you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
At the time of the prophet Joel in our first reading, natural disasters were put down to God being angry and inflicting punishment on the people for their sins. So when a plague of locusts stripped the land of everything green and devastated Judea, the home of God's chosen people, five or more centuries before the time of Jesus, people believed that it was God punishing them for their sins. So we find the prophet in the first reading, prophet Joel, pleading with the people and urging them to turn back to the Lord with all their heart, fasting, weeping, mourning. He orders a fast from the highest to the lowest, so that God, who is rich in mercy and slow to anger, will hear their prayer and see their earnest acts of penitence and avert the disaster caused by the locusts. Everyone is urged to put themselves right with God, to turn back to Him in order to mend a broken and chaotic world. This is the true meaning of conversion. And conversion is what Lent is all about, a personal turning back to the Lord, being reconciled with Him, so that we can repair that bit of the chaos in the world that we are personally responsible for. St. James asks, where do all these wars and battles between yourselves first start? Isn't it precisely in the desires fighting within your own selves? All the conflicts in the world, whether they be the rows and bitter hurts that cause marriage breakdown, or the greed for power and world dominion that spawn world wars, all these tragic events start within the human heart. And so Joel insists on inner conversion, a real and effective change of heart. He speaks for God when he says, "Come back to me with all your heart." Pope Francis says of this passage, "With all one's heart means taking the path of conversion that is neither superficial nor transient, but is a spiritual journey that reaches the deepest place of the self." The kind of conversion Lent asks of us is a real, deep, and permanent one. To my shame, when I look back on my life, I think the only permanent change I succeeded making in any Lent was giving up sugar in my tea about 40 years ago. And that was scarcely a deep spiritual change in my life. The challenge of Lent is at least in part to make permanent the changes we decide to embrace in Lent. The simple logic being that if we can endure acts of penitence for 6 weeks, if we can succeed in good works for the duration of Lent, if we can commit to prayer for this season, we can do it forever thereafter. The Gospel offers us the three traditional means of penitence and conversion: prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Whatever you decide to do to keep Lent in your own way, perhaps choose something from each of these traditional activities, some new commitment to daily prayer, some charitable act of giving alms, or giving your time to help some needy cause, and some element of fasting, whether it be to give up something in your usual diet that you like, go vegan, or fast 1 or 2 days a week. Whatever you decide to do, let it be sincere and motivated by an authentic desire to be reconciled to God and to change your life in some way for the better, because you are in Christ. That way, God will be in it with you and will not only support you, but will enable the growth in his life in your heart that could change you for the good forever. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that he be pleased to bless these ashes with the abundance of his grace. We will put them on our heads in penitence. O God, who desire not the death of sinners but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers, and in your kindness be pleased to bless these ashes which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we who acknowledge we are but ashes and shall return to dust may, through a steadfast observance of Lent, gain pardon for sins and newness of life after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Repent and believe the Gospel.
Remember, you are dust, and to dust you shall return.
And so let us now express our faith as we join together in the Apostles' Creed, which we will use during Lent. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. So let us now turn to God our Father in prayer as we ask during this Lenten season to turn back to him with all our hearts.
Lord, we pray, teach us to be humble and to accept our failings so that your grace may be at work in us to turn us back to you. Lord, in your mercy. Father, enrich us with the means to grow ever deeper into your love and help us to embrace the disciplines of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving this Lent. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, may our heartfelt prayers for all suffering from the coronavirus and those fighting it on the front line bear fruit in an end to the epidemic and a return to health and well-being in our communities. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for the infirm and fearful at this time, that they may grow in confidence as vaccination takes control of the disease. Lord, in your mercy. Father, we pray for all those in the world who do not have the luxury of clean running water. May our efforts to raise funds this Lent help to relieve their situation and bring clean water to their villages and homes. Lord, in your mercy. We commend to your care, Heavenly Father, all those who have died recently, especially Sister Martin and Sister Jenny, and those of our family and acquaintance who have succumbed to the virus. Lord, in your mercy. We pray in silence for our own particular needs. We call upon the intercession of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, Our Lady and Saint Peter, as we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers, be our guide and accompany us on this journey of Lent, so that we may enter more deeply into our life with you, through Christ our Lord.
Ashes to ashes, from dust unto dust, the cross on our forehead, your promise, O God, ready us to follow the way of your Son, to rise from these ashes, redeemed in the fire of your love. Sound the trumpet in Zion, announce from the Lord that the day of God's favor is ever close at hand. Ashes to ashes, from dust unto dust, the cross on our forehead, your promise, O God, ready us to follow the way of your Son, to rise from these ashes, redeemed in the fire of your love. Rend your hearts, not your garments, return to the Lord, who delights when we offer a truly humble heart. Ashes to ashes, from dust unto dust, the cross on our forehead, your promise, O God, ready us to follow the way of your Son, to rise from these ashes, redeemed in the fire of your love. We have seen in the heavens and held in our arms what the hand of our Maker can fashion out of dust. Ashes to ashes, from dust unto dust, the cross on our forehead, your promise, O God, ready us to follow the way of your Son, to rise from these ashes, redeemed in the fire of your love.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through the works of penance and charity we may turn away from harmful pleasures and, cleansed from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when he was about to give his life to set us free, he reclined at supper. He himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrament of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Philip, our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Attende Domine et miserere, quia peccavimus tibi. Ater exsume omnium redemptor. nostros sublevamus frentes. Exaudi Christe, supplicantum preces. Attende Domine et miserere, quia peccavimus tibi. Dextera Patris lapis angularis, via salutis Janua celestis, ablue nostri macula delicti. Attende Domine et miserere, quia peccavimus tibi. Rogamus Deus tua majestatem, oribus sacris gemitus exaudi, crimina nostra placidus indulge. Attende Domine et miserere, quia peccavimus tibi.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Pour out a spirit of compunction, O God, on those who bow before your majesty, and by your mercy may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Turn to winter and sunshine turn to See you.